Greetings of the day, sir. My name is Achal Gathir, and today in this video, I am going to talk about human trafficking, its meaning, the statutes regulating human trafficking in India, and the Supreme Court judgments related to it. The topic of trafficking was in news recently because Ministry of Women and Child Development has come up with a bill, that is Trafficking in Humans Prevention, Care and Rehabilitation Bill 2021, and has asked suggestions from the people of India on it till 15th of July 2021, and the bill is currently under examination. So, what is the meaning of human trafficking? Human trafficking basically means trafficking of humans for the purpose of slavery, prostitution, forced marriage, exploitation, sexual exploitation, and etc. It has a very wide ambit which has been included in the definition of human trafficking of the bill. Now let's talk about what are the statutes before this bill which govern human trafficking in India. The first one is of course Article 23 of the Constitution, which has prohibited human trafficking. The second is Section 370 and 370A of the Indian Penal Code 1860, which has varied definition of human trafficking and has included the ruthless punishments also to the criminals. Also, there are various statutes which has particular sections regarding human trafficking and its punishment to criminals. For example, Section 3Z of the Scheduled Castes and Scheduled Tribes Prevention and Atrocities Act 1989, Section 9 of the Bonded Labour System Abolition Act 1976, Section 5 of the Immoral Traffic Prevention Act 1956, Section 13 Clause 20 of the Goa Children's Act 2003, Section 19 of the Transportation of Organs and Tissues Act 1994. Moreover, there are some state-centric legislations also which has covered the punishments related to human trafficking. Now, let's talk about the Supreme Court and High Court judgments related to human trafficking. The first one is People's Union for Democratic Rights versus Union of India, 1982, 3 SCC 235. In this case, the Supreme Court has taken the cognizance of increasing human trafficking in India and has given a definition of forced labor also. The second one is Vishal Jeet versus Union of India, 1990, 3 SCC 318. In this case, the Supreme Court has directed the state governments and the central government for forming a committee regarding human trafficking, and also the Supreme Court has given the directions to the central government and state government for taking care for the prevention of human trafficking in India. The third case is Gaurav Jain versus Union of India, 1997, 8 SCC 144. In this case, the Supreme Court has formed a committee to analyze, to research on the prostitution and child prostitution so that the victims of the same can be rescued and rehabilitated. The fourth case is Lakshmikant Pandey versus Union of India, 1984, 2 SCC 244. In this case, basically the Supreme Court has given the cognizance for the adoption of children so that the children are not trafficked. The fifth case is of Bombay High Court, which is Prerna versus State of Maharashtra, 2003, 2 MAH LJ 105. In this case, the Bombay High Court has given 7 guidelines regarding the trafficking of humans and their prevention, rehabilitation and care of the victims. So, what is the conclusion? The bill, Trafficking in Humans Prevention, Care and Rehabilitation Bill 2021, is a right direction of the Parliament, because there was ambiguity and a lot of confusion before regarding the human trafficking, and people were unaware of the prevention of human trafficking. So let's see what happens after the examination of all the suggestions given by the people and what comprehensive bill comes in the Parliament. Thank you.